Hello everyone, welcome back again to FN Engineering channel. Today, we are going to discuss 5 thickness calculation based on international standard, ASME Section 8 Division 1. In this video, we will learn some important things in calculating 5 thickness, including reference, formula, and study cases. Well, here are the overviews of this explanation. First of all, we will determine the reference for 5 thickness calculation using ASME Section 8 Division 1 standard. Next, we will find the formula for the calculation. After that, we will detail the formula to know the symbols and their definition from the formula. Finally, we will practice some study cases to calculate 5 thickness. Go to the next slide. In this slide, we will know some use reference for thickness calculation. The use main reference is mandatory appendix 1, especially in paragraph 1.1, equation 1. In addition, we need some data from the database. For pipe dimension, we refer to ASME B36.10 standards. Meanwhile, for the material properties, we use ASME Section 2D metric for the metric unit, or Section 2D customary for the US customary unit. In the next slide, we will know the formula for a pipe thickness calculation referred to Appendix 1, paragraph 1.1. Here are the formulas. The left one is for calculating the minimum required thickness. Meanwhile, the right one is for calculating the maximum allowable working pressure. Well, next, we will describe the definition of each symbol from these formulas. First, T. T is the minimum required thickness in millimeter unit. Then, P. P is the internal descent pressure in MPa unit. Next, there is RO. RO is the outside radius of pipe in millimeter unit. After that is S. S is allowable stress of pipe material in MPa unit. Then E. E is joint efficiency. The value of joint efficiency in the pipe is commonly 1. Lastly is P at the right equation, which is the maximum allowable working pressure in MPa unit. Well, turn on to the study cases. We will solve 3 study cases for pipe thickness calculation. In the first study case, we will determine the nominal thickness and maximum allowable working pressure of the pipe with some given information, such as pipe material using SA106 grade B and pipe dimension using nominal pipe schedule 10 inch. Then, for design conditions, internal descent pressure is 1000 kilopascal and internal descent temperature is 100 degrees Celsius. Secondly, we will also determine the nominal thickness and maximum allowable working pressure of the pipe with some given information. Pipe material is stainless steel, material using SA312TP304 with dimension nominal pipe schedule 4 inch and welded pipe. Meanwhile, the descent conditions are descent pressure 2 MPa and descent temperature 200 degrees Celsius. In the last study case, we will also calculate the nominal thickness and MAWP for the tube. The tube is typically used for heat transfer. The material for the tube in the study case is carbon steel SA179 with an outside diameter 1 inch. Meanwhile, the descent condition is the same as the second study case, descent pressure 2 MPa and descent temperature 200 degrees Celsius. Well, we'll solve some study cases using a Google Spreadsheet. First, we copy some data to Spreadsheet such as question, formula, dimension, and material properties. We have copied all data for study case 1. We start to make a calculation sheet for pipe thickness calculation. Without a description, symbol, study case 1, unit, and remarks. Next, we write all parameters based on the formula at Appendix 1.1, Equation 1. Internal distance pressure, internal distance temperature, outside diameter, outside radius, material, allowable stress, joint efficiency, corrosion allowance. We write the symbol for all parameters such as P, internal distance pressure, T, internal distance temperature, S, allowable stress, GO, outside diameter, RO, outside radius, E, joint efficiency, and CA, corrosion allowance. Next, we fill the value and unit. Internal distance pressure 1000 kPa, internal distance pressure 1000 kilopascal or 1 megapascal, internal distance temperature 100 degrees Celsius, material SA 106 grade B, allowable stress we find at ASME section 2D metric 118 MPa. Next, outside diameter we find at ASME B36.10 273 mm. The outside radius is outside diameter divided by 2, which is 136.5 mm. Joint efficiency is 1 for seamless pipe. Then we assume a corrosion allowance 3 mm. After that, we calculate the minimum required thickness using equation 1 from Appendix 1.1. Minimum required thickness is equal distance pressure. Minimum required thickness is equal distance pressure P multiplied by outside radius RO, then divided by allowable stress S multiplied by joint efficiency E, added by 0.4 multiplied by internal distance pressure P. Lastly, don't forget to add corrosion allowance 3 mm. Well, we get 4.15 mm for the minimum required thickness. In the next step, we determine the nominal thickness. We need additional parameters such as nominal thickness, finished thickness, and the conclusion, is thickness acceptable or not. We assume nominal thickness based on the value of required thickness. We assume schedule 40 or 9.27 mm from ASME B36.10. Next, for finished thickness, we have to consider pipe handle tolerance 12.5%. So, we multiply nominal thickness with 0.875, we get 8.11 mm. Lastly, the conclusion. The thickness is acceptable if the finished thickness or TF is larger or equal to the required thickness or T. Lastly, we calculate maximum allowable working pressure or MAWP. In order to calculate MAWP, we define T in this formula that T is finished thickness minus corrosion allowance. We input the parameter into the formula. MAWP is allowable stress S multiplied by joint efficiency multiplied by finished thickness minus corrosion allowance. Then divided by outside radius minus 0.4 multiplied by finished thickness minus corrosion allowance. We get 4.49 MPa. We also can change the nominal thickness using different schedules. We will use schedule 40 for this case. Well, we have solved study case 1. Before we continue, we will give the color to make easy the calculation sheet. We give for different parameters or colors such as input data, data from the database, assumed data, and calculated data. We give yellow color for input data. orange color for data from the database, blue color for assumed data, and green color for calculated data. We give yellow color for internal design pressure, internal design temperature, and pipe material. Then, we give orange color for allowable stress and outside diameter. For the outside radius, we give green color. Joint efficiency and corrosion allowance are assumed data. Minimum required thickness is calculated data. Nominal thickness is data from the database. Finished thickness is assumed data. Conclusion for thickness and MAWP, we give them a green color. Well, we have solved study case 1. Next, we will solve the study case 2. We insert a new column. We copy all data from study case 1. Then, we copy some data such as dimension for nominal pipe schedule for inch and properties material for SA312TP304. We will check again all parameters. Internal design pressure is 2 MPa. Internal design temperature is 200 degrees Celsius. Material is SA312TP304 welded. The allowable stress, we use 107 MPa based on this data. The outside diameter is 114.3 mm. So, the outside radius is 57.15 mm. Joint efficiency is 1 because welded pipe factor has been included in allowable stress based on the notes in ASME section 2D for SA312 materials. Next, for the corrosion allowance, we assume 0 mm for stainless steel material. Well, we get 1.06 mm for the minimum required thickness. After that, we assume the nominal thickness. We use schedule 40 or 6.02 mm. We get the finished thickness 5.27 and MAWP 10.24 MPa. Well, we have solved study case 2. We get nominal thickness 6.02 mm or schedule 40 and MAWP 10.24 MPa. Lastly, we will solve study case 3 for the tube. We also copy all parameters from the study case 2. We copy additional data for material properties of the tube material, which is for SA179. We check again all parameters. Design pressure is 2 MPa. Design temperature is 200 degrees Celsius. Material is SA179. Allowable stress is 92.4 MPa. The offset diameter is 25.4 mm. So, the offset radius is 12.7 mm. Joint efficiency is 1 for the tube. And typically, there is no corrosion allowance for the tube. Next, we copy the nominal thickness for the tube. The tube thickness is usually used BWG standard dimension. We assume BWG 18 thickness for this case. The thickness is 1.245 mm. So, the finished thickness is 1.09 mm. For information, the tube has two options for the thickness, which are average wall thickness and minimum wall thickness. For the average wall thickness, we have to consider the tube under tolerance, 12.5%. Meanwhile, for the minimum wall thickness, the tube under tolerance is not required to be added in the calculation. We use average wall thickness for this case. Lastly, the MAWP for study case 3 is 8.21 MPa. Well, we have solved all study cases. For study case 1, we get 9.27 mm or schedule 40 for the nominal thickness and 4.49 MPa for the MAWP. Then, for study case 2, we get 6.02 mm or schedule 40 for the nominal thickness and 10.24 MPa for the MAWP. And then, for study case 3, we get BWG 18 or 1.245 mm for the average wall thickness and 8.21 MPa for the MAWP. Alright everyone, thank you for watching my video. If you have some comments or suggestions, please write on the comment column. And if you get something new from this video, please like my video, subscribe to my channel, and turn on the notification from this channel to get an updated video from FN Engineering channel. And don't forget to share this video or FN Engineering channel with others. See you next time!